Today's video is brought to you by Squarespace. Whether you need a domain, website, or online store, make it with Squarespace. One of my favorite creators recently has been Peter McKinnon. Let me pull up some of his videos for you. And if you've been paying attention to some of his recent videos, like here's a good one, you might have noticed these animations and motion graphics that he's been using in his videos. And I thought it was a really cool style, so in today's video I wanted to show you how you could replicate and recreate those effects for yourself. As usual, the software I'm using is called HipFilm, but the idea of this video is that the software you're using shouldn't really matter and shouldn't prevent you from following along with the tutorial. The idea of this video is to give you ideas and concepts for effects you can use, not necessarily show you what button to press and what number to type in. There's nothing wrong with tutorials like that, that's just not what this is. So if there's an effect or a concept in this video that you're not quite familiar with, there are other tutorials online that'll give you a more in-depth look into how you can pull that off. But if you are familiar with those concepts, let's get into it. But first, let me let my cat out of my room. Give me 1 second. The motion graphics he uses are very minimal. They're all white, and the fonts are very simple and modern. To create the different shapes and elements, I'm just going to be using white plain or solid layers. You can change the resolution of these layers or mask them to create different boxes and lines, or you could use an effect like polar coordinates or polar warp to make a circular shape. There's a lot of different tools and techniques that you can use to create different kinds of shapes, so no matter what kind of graphic you're going for, chances are if you're just creative and think about it, you can find something and some way to create that shape. Chances are you'll have multiple different shapes and you want some of them to move together, so the way you can do that is by parenting one layer to another, then it'll basically stick to it, and anywhere that first layer goes, the one that's parented to it will move around with it. Once you're finished with that graphic, select all of the layers that you use to make it and make that into its own composite shot. Now you have all of those separate layers condensed down into one graphic, and if you need to use it in multiple shots, you can just drag and drop that composition wherever you need to use it. After you drag that graphic on top of your footage, just lower the opacity a bit and try out different blend modes like add or screen to figure out what looks most realistic for your shot. Now that we've created that graphic, I want to show you the different ways that you can animate it and composite it into your scene. But before that, I want to take a quick second to talk about Squarespace, which is the sponsor of today's video. If you clicked on this video, chances are you're a creator of some kind. And in that case, it's great to have a website to showcase your brand, a portfolio to display your work, or an online store to sell your LUTs, your presets, your merchandise. And Squarespace is an amazing and easy way to make that. It's an all-in-one platform with nothing to install, patch, or upgrade. And even if you still manage to get something wrong, they have 24/7 customer service to help out. Now I get that as filmmakers and creators, a lot of you want your site to look really nice, and that's why Squarespace offers designer templates to make your site look amazing while still giving you the flexibility to make it your own. This way you can ensure that your site looks as great as your work, because no matter what you're creating, I'm sure it's incredible, and your site will be too if you make it with Squarespace. So go to squarespace.com for a free trial, and when you're ready to launch, go to squarespace.com/Aiden to get 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain. That being said, let's talk a bit about compositing these graphics into your shots, starting out with motion tracking. Probably the coolest thing about these animations is that they move around to follow his hand, and that's actually not too difficult to do. Just use a single point track to track the location of your finger throughout the shot, then add a new point layer to your composition and attach the track to that point. Finally, just take that graphic we created in the first part of this video and parent it to the point layer, and as you can see if you play through your footage, it should follow your finger throughout the scene. If you watch Peter McKinnon's videos closely, you can probably notice that there's a quick animation whenever one of these graphics appears. To create one of these animations for yourself, find the frame where you want the graphic to be visible and set a keyframe for the scale and opacity. Then go back about 10 or so frames and change the scale and opacity both to 0. Then just finish it off by using your editing software's value graph or graph editor function to smooth out those animations and enable motion blur. And you don't necessarily have to animate the scale, you could also change the rotation or position even. And one final subtle detail that Peter McKinnon occasionally adds to these animations is to blur out the background. To recreate this, just drag and drop a blur effect onto your footage, and when that animation happens, keyframe the blur to go from 0 to a small amount of blur, nothing too heavy or it's not going to look realistic. And at this point, if you've done everything right, you should have an animation that looks pretty close to those used by Peter McKinnon. And as I usually say in these videos about recreating other creators' effects, you're not going to get very far by just taking these animations and pasting them point for point into your own videos. This is an effect where there are a lot of opportunities to be creative by changing things like the fonts, the colors, the animations. Just like any other effect, it's very important to do it differently, be creative, and make it your own. But that being said, I do hope you've learned something from this video, and if you did, do feel free to share your support by leaving a like on the video, sharing it with your friends, or even subscribing to my channel. I upload 2 new filmmaking tutorials every single week. But that's all for now. Keep creating, and I'll see you in the next one.